you must have governance structure countrywide. You must have activities and representation countrywide. With all due respect, the federation like swimming, what league do they have? Do they have swimming association in Kisoro, in Karamoja? But it has been registered. And you say FUFA, because it doesn't have the trusteeship, but has a representation in all districts of Uganda, is running activities from all districts of Uganda, up national activities, has meetings, general assembly, structures, and some of these federations don't even have structures, even at the national level. But because they don't have trusteeship, you say will not appeal to them. The question is, these declarations do not say you must have these are mandatory and these are not mandatory. In the absence of law, it means all the regulations are a must. Alright? That's what the law says. Unless specified, all regulations are a must. So which scorecard is National Council supposed to be using to say actually complies with the regulations because they have the trusteeship, but they don't have activities countrywide, not even national, that they are more qualified than who?
Actually, it's a family federation.
You get my point? The regulations and the compliance must be equal to all members. There should not be exceptions that this one, because they don't talk, will give them. This one, because they talk, we shall not give them. We want to have a structured scorecard that is not biased to ensure that everybody complies, because these regulations are meant, one, to force a government to the game countrywide for every sport. So if you're going to give exceptions to one sport, how will that sport grow? It cannot grow. So let's have a fair play for all federations to meet the requirements and go.